Yo, what's up guys? Today we are reacting to this video about the ISRO, the Indian Space Research Organization. And the title of this video is India's ISRO the most successful space agency after NASA? Well, let's take a look at this video. This video was actually published 4 years ago, so I'm sure that by now there are some recent and, you know, new developments. So right now we're going to watch this one, but I'm pretty sure there are new information out there. I don't know if ISRO has passed NASA, or I don't know. We're going to watch it. We're going to learn about it. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to like and subscribe. If this is the type of video you want to see more, let me know in the comments. Let's go.
This video is supported by Brilliant. Hey, welcome back, I'm Lai. On this channel, I've talked a lot about technology and business space companies. I've talked about national agencies like NASA, ESA, and Roscosmos.
You're too loud for me. Wait a second. Was it too loud? Okay, let's go.
I've also talked about private companies like SpaceX and Rocket Lab. One entity I've refrained to talk about is ISRO, the Indian Space Research Organization, simply because it's really hard to pigeonhole ISRO. Yes, it is a traditional national agency, much like NASA of the United States, but it's also at the same time extremely cost-conscious and result-oriented like a startup. Its launch price is almost as competitive as SpaceX. So let's talk about it today. Where does ISRO really fit in, and what makes it so special? First,
what makes it so special? It's one of the, well, I don't know, let's watch it.
First of all, it is not fair to compare ISRO with other space agencies because ISRO has never possessed the ambitions or the fundings like the other space agencies.
But aren't they the first ones to go to Mars? Aren't they the first ones to actually, there's I haven't watched Rocketeery, but I think that's part of the ISRO, right? But I've seen a video talking about the first rocket that went to Mars. You know,
NASA's budget each year is $18 billion. $7 billion for European Space Agency, $3 billion for the Chinese and the Russians.
Wow.
ISRO's budget each year is only $1.7 billion.
Goodness.
Think about it. With $285 billion cash reserve, Apple could have funded ISRO with cash for 167 years.
Wow.
That is how little
cash
ISRO spends every year, and that is why comparing ISRO with NASA wouldn't be fair.
Why don't people invest more in Indian technology? I don't understand that. I mean, come on, Indian cinema, everything is made on a smaller budget and the quality is as good as Hollywood. You know, all of the, I'm getting angry. You know, although I know that India doesn't need foreign investment, I know that, but it would be so more beneficial if, you know, if they had the budget of the United States. Of course, everything comes with, you know, strings attached. But if imagine if it was for the benefit of the world, you know. But then again, if the United States doesn't invest in India, don't worry. There are so many Indians that go to the United States and, you know, become CEOs and, you know, they do their job. And not only India, you know, if you, I haven't said this before, but Brazil, you know, there are Brazilians everywhere, including Facebook. You know, he was one of the founders of Facebook. Anyways, Brazil and India were always there, so that's why, you know, I'm always supportive of India. And
however, this is not to say that ISRO has not achieved extraordinary results. It has. Two of the most successful launches of ISRO
was
the PSLV C-37 in 2017 and the Mangoyaan in 2013. PSLV C-37 until this day holds the record for launching the most satellites in a single rocket, and Mangoyaan successfully helped ISRO to become the fourth country to orbit Mars, even before the Chinese. But none of the aforementioned...
Wasn't it the first? I know it was the first try, right?
...mentioned achievements comes close to what ISRO has spent for both missions.
104 satellites in one launch. Do you know what that means, man? Successfully.
Around $70 million each. This, I think, reflects the core philosophy of ISRO, which is to be ambitious, but at the same time, cost-effective. In the 1960s, the Soviet Union and the United States competed fiercely in the space industry, which eventually accelerated the collapse of the Soviet Union, and now the Chinese are catching up with the Americans. Not to compete with NASA this time, but the Chinese are not going to be anyone else's lackey either. Therefore, while other space agencies compete to make the most powerful rockets in the world, ISRO never seemed to care about that. Just look at the evolution of its rocket launchers. They're all humbly named satellite launch vehicles. Different variations indicated by the first letter represent different orbit.
See, that's the thing about India. You guys, you don't want to compete. You just want to do your job and you just want to be successful. I don't see, you know, humbleness is one of the biggest things in India that I can see. Not only humbleness, but family, you know, all of that. It's very important. And you can see this with the army also. India doesn't want to attack anyone. They just want to defend. You know, with the movies also, they don't want to compete with other industries. They just want to make entertainment for their own, even their own film industry. You know, before movies like Bahubali, before KGF, you know, the movies were just like pertaining to a specific industry, the Telugu, you know, the Kannada, Malayalam, they were just in one Tamil, Hindi, one industry. And then they would just remake other industries' movies. And now that they are pan-India, you know, it's a little bit more competitive now, but still, it's still the same mentality. I'm making the movie for me and, you know, so that my people can enjoy it. And, you know, they don't do it to show off to Hollywood or anything like that. Nowadays, because it's so good, you can see that RRR is you know, winning the Golden Globes, they're gonna win the Oscars, that's for sure. So that's so interesting. You know, we have like one of the biggest businessmen in India, Tata, who he's not a showboat. You know, he gives away his money to charity, and you know, he's not trying to show off or anything. And that's what I love about that. You know, it's not to glorify themselves, but they do it because it's their duty, and you know, they're just helping their own country. That is just something that is intriguing to me. You know, it's not about the money, it's not about the success, it's not about the fame or anything like that. It's just about getting the job done, the duty, you know.
PSLV for polar synchronous orbit and GSLV for geosynchronous orbit. This is the first clue of how pragmatic ISRO is. The second clue is in its vehicle design. If you take a closer look at ISRO's rocket evolution, it looks almost like SpaceX. The only difference is that ISRO has a more stable financial support from the Indian government and SpaceX had none. But in terms of the
I would say India is a secret worker, a silent worker. When you notice India, they're already miles ahead of you, you know. And that's different for some other countries. Some other countries have the mission to show you that they're better, you know. And at the end of the day, people who want to show stuff aren't really, you know, what they're cut out. You know, they're not what they say.
The approach to design launch vehicles, both organizations are very similar. SLV and ASLV was initiated in the 1980s, and ASLV's capability is similar to that of Falcon 1. The three versions of PSLVs have similar capabilities comparing to early versions of Falcon 9, and the GSLV has capabilities somewhat catching on to Falcon 9 Block 5. None of them could be classified as a super heavy lift launch vehicle like Falcon Heavy and Saturn V, but they're all super reliable and most importantly, very cost effective. What's more impressive about the evolution of ISRO's launch vehicles is their adaptability. Take PSLV as an example. It has three versions. PSLV-CA, which stands for Core Alone, Standard PSLV, and PSLV-XL. While all of them focus on polar synchronous orbit, which is around 600 kilometers altitude, customers can choose which variations of vehicles to use based on the size of the satellite. This is the beauty of a cost-effective launcher. Furthermore, because of its focus on cost-effectiveness, ISRO also has to come up with brilliant engineering solutions to the problems it faces. One famous example is its experimental mission to Mars. On top of being the only
experimental mission, and they succeeded. It was just experimental.
Only successful Mars mission on the first try, ISRO had to perform 6 orbit-raising maneuvers over 3 weeks before heading to Mars.
Wow.
Because the vehicle does not have enough power like the Falcon Heavy
like to
send satellites directly to Mars, it slowly raises the satellite's orbit before injecting it successfully to a heliocentric orbit to Mars. The engineering and the problem-solving behind it is truly amazing. This, I think, captures the essence of ISRO's success. As the founding father of
It's not about the money, I've said it, you know. It doesn't matter also, like, we have people that have a lot of money, but if they don't know what to do with the money or how to do the job, money isn't everything, you know. It's all about being smart and, you know, doing what you need to do with the resources that you have at your hand.
Of ISRO, Vikram used to say...
Vikram? Okay, let me go back.
...of ISRO, Vikram is the essence of ISRO's success. As the founding father of ISRO, Vikram used to say, there are some who question the relevance of space activities in the developing nation. To us, there's no ambiguity of purpose. We do not have the fantasy of competing with the economically advanced nations in the exploration of the moon or the planets or manned space flight. But we're convinced that if we're to play a meaningful role nationally and in the community of nations, we must be second to none in the applications of advanced technologies to the real problems of men and society.
See, that's the thing. When you have a strong leader, a strong founder, someone who has their thoughts in the right place, their vision, their mentality, and their worth ethics in the right place, then, you know, the whole generation that comes after him will have the same reference and the same knowledge as the leader who started it. So if you have a weak leader who starts something, most of the time it doesn't go anywhere. But in the instance that it does go somewhere, the future generations will still say, oh, but the founding father or the founder used to think like this and that. So they are not going to progress in the right mentality. So it needs to start right to continue doing, without them.
I think this is the key to understand what ISRO stands for and how it differs from other space agencies and companies. This is also why I said at the beginning, it is really hard to pigeonhole ISRO. It didn't have the fundings that NASA had, it didn't have the startup mindset and institution that SpaceX had, but none of this stopped ISRO from doing something extraordinary. This just comes to show how important passion and dedication is for any organization. You know, talking about ISRO makes me really happy because it's clearly made out of people who are passionate, dedicated, and above all, an institution that encourages it. Looking forward into the future, I think ISRO will continue to do great things. It's setting out to perform its first manned mission in 2022. I'd say good luck to ISRO. Before I pop-
How was that mission? That was last year. Did it go through? I need more information on that.
Published this video, one of my viewers sent me this picture. Can you believe it? In the early days, engineers of ISRO had to send rocket parts with their bicycles to assemble them for testing.
Oh. Okay, I thought he was actually putting a rocket on the bike. That would go really fast, but it would be very dangerous, you know, to burn your behind. But wow, they had to transport on bikes because of the budget.
This is the situation they had to deal with every single day.
Passion.
They don't have a lot of resources. What they do have is passion and dedication.
He used the right word.
They only achieved what they did through hard work and a lot of practice. A good way to practice actively, though, is through brilliant.org.
Okay, I can see that this is a sponsored message. Okay, so I think that's the whole video, the gist of the video. Guys, honestly, I am pretty amazed what India can do with the limited budget and the limited resources. And I have always thought that the human mind and manpower is all you need in order to, you know, succeed. So if you have the education, if you have the mind, the passion, you can go anywhere. It is not the environment that you were born into that will dictate where you go. In fact, there's actually a saying that says that an egg is made hard and soft by... I need to think of this properly. So the potato and the egg can be made hard and soft with the same water. So if you boil an egg, it becomes hard. If you boil a potato, it becomes soft. So it is not the environment that affects what is within you. Okay? So be the egg or be the potato. It doesn't matter. Use this as you wish. If you are... I don't know if I said that right. But it is not the environment that will affect what you have inside. Okay? It is you who are the ones who need to dictate your future. So anything is possible. And you guys can, you know, that's the thing about India. They have proven time and time again that they can do anything. Okay, anything. I'm not very good with metaphors or speeches or anything like that. And that's not the intention. I just remembered this saying. And I don't know if I've said it correctly, but hey. I'll see you on the next video. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.